Hi, today we're going to continue talking about socioculturalism, and we're going to talk specifically about applications of socioculturalism to the classroom. So our guiding questions today are, how can we measure shared knowledge, and what interventions can help facilitate this shared knowledge? So remember the apprenticeship model, we have our culturally valued activity with a novice who's attempting to make sense of the situation. We have our skilled partner who's helping find ways to make that shared thinking happen. We have that explicit and tacit communication with supportive structuring and transfer of responsibility with our group of novices and peers that are resources for each other that create this apprenticeship model. So how do we assess how we've gained in this culturally valued activity? And so the first way is it's really not just about whether or not they can do it, but about the quality of that culturally valued activity and knowing that it's on a scale and knowing that it's going from novice to skilled. So you're going to have some sort of performance evaluation. That could be a rubric, that could be a descriptor. For this class, I'm asking you to really think about how you could measure this, but I'm not, we you haven't taken assessment yet, so I'm not expecting this to be a full-blown rubric per se. You can find one on the internet perhaps, or you can create your own. You can make it a simple checklist with descriptions, or it can be more of a full-blown analytic rubric. And that this assessment should be contextually situated. So thinking about the developmental age of your participants, thinking about where they are in life and what the context is for them performing this task is going to be really important for your evaluation of the task. So you would evaluate a 3-year-old tying their shoes really differently than you would evaluate a 38-year-old tying their shoes, right? So thinking about all of those contextual issues as well. So this is an example of a description analysis. This is one way that you could evaluate a task. So I just want to give you an example. This is a telescope task on levels 1, 2, and 3. And remember, you're going to evaluate before and after your intervention. So what would this intervention look like if you're really thinking about this shared task, this shared learning? You could think about a intervention that it relied upon both tacit and explicit communication. You really want to talk about in your lab what your tacit and explicit communications were. So how are you modeling and showing them how to do something both explicitly outlining it for them and also by tacitly showing them? A transfer of responsibility where you're taking the bulk of something and gradually letting them do more and more. Think about when you learned to cook and your mom first did most of the mixing, and then gradually you had to hold the spoon more and more, and then finally you were putting the cake in the oven yourself, right? Supportive structuring. So how could you provide the support needed? Maybe with manipulatives when you're talking about teaching someone to add, you're adding that scaffolding, that structuring to help them learn or help them do something. A peer aid or a challenge. So when we learn in a group, and this goes along with that community of practice. So when you're learning as a group, going through something together, how does that help you become part of that community of practice or that community of learners? So think about exploring a book together in a book club or becoming part of a club or an organization, even in an online space, what that looks like. So these are possible interventions for your task. And remember that you're going to measure using your assessment techniques both before and after your intervention for the lab activity. So that's all I have for applications. I hope you have a great day, guys. Bye.